Hi, my name is Greg Kleinhenz, and I'm with Matrix Technologies. In this video, I'd like to go over an introduction and basic setup of a PID controller in the RSLogix 5000 environment. For this example, I'll be connected to an L63 processor, and I'll be using version 20 of Logix. So to start off with, a PID controller is a proportional, integral, and derivative controller. It is used to control a specific process variable to a desired value. The typical values associated with a PID controller are the PV, or process variable, which is the part of the process that we want to control, the CV, or the control variable, the thing that we will change to achieve that control, and the SP, the set point. This is the set value that we want the PV to go to. Lastly, you have the error, which is the deviation between the set point and the process variable. The PID controller uses an equation to constantly calculate the error and uses the PI and D terms to calculate a correction, which is then fed back into, which is then used to calculate the control variable. The proportional term acts on the current value of the error, the integral term acts on the cumulative error over time, and the derivative term works on the rate of change of the error. Note that the derivative is not always needed in many applications for adequate control. For my example, I've set up two separate routines. One contains simulation logic, and then the other contains the controller. So for this example, I chose to do a level loop in a tank. So for our simulation logic, I have first a update timer that will update the simulation every half second. I simulate a flow control valve that is feeding, let's say, water into this tank. It's commanded to 0 to 100%, and the flow associated with that 0 to 100% is 0 to 100 gallons per second. So moving on, for the outflow, I've got two solenoid valves, and when either is open, each would put out 30 gallons per second. The overall volume simulation for the tank is relatively straightforward. Just note that I'm doing I'm simulating a 2000 gallon tank. And to do that, I'm just, again, every half second updating the volume based on the flows that are going in and out. I then tie back the volume to the level, which then obviously goes back to the PID controller. So the PID controller will be using the level as the process variable, the 0 to 100% output on the flow control valve as the control variable. The set point will be something that we will adjust as needed. And then it will act based on the error between our entered set point and the current value of the level. So right now I have one of my two solenoid valves open, so I do have some outflow, and then I currently have the controller set to 25% on the level, and it is trying to hold that against the outflow that's going out through the solenoid valve. In ladder logic, this is what your PID instruction is going to look like. You will have to associate a PID tag with it, And then you will then tie in your process variable. In this case, again, that's the level in the tank. Your control variable, which is our flow control valve, which is going into the tank. And then it is calculating this output percent. The I did not specify a tieback because I'm not using that in this example. PID master loop is set to zero because this is just a simple singular PID controller. It's not cascaded, so that's why I'm not using the master loop function. I did not set up a bumpless transfer, so that's why the in-hold bit and in-hold values are both zero. So now I'm just going to go into the PID configuration to show you what I have in there. So right now the set point is reading what's being moved into the PID controller from this PID underscore 001 underscore set point flat tag that I have set up. It is calculating this set output in real time. I did not set up an output bias, so that's why it's zero. And I currently have the proportional gain set to 0.25 and the integral gain set to 1, and I'm not using any derivative gain. Specific details on PID tuning is a bit out of the scope for this example. But suffice to say, you can adjust the PI and D gain values to achieve more precise control or more stable or quicker a quicker response time for changes in set point or a better response to variations in the process. So say, you know, if in this example, if the level were to suddenly drop because I opened the other solenoid valve, that would be example of a process variation, whereas the set point changing would be something we would change. In either case, getting better PI and D tuning would get us better control or faster control and responses to any of those types of changes. Moving on to the configuration tab, I typically use the independent gains for the PID equation. The control action, you have two options, either PV minus SP or SP minus PV. You can use that to flip the direction of your control action if you need to. Derivative, I usually keep it on PV. The loop update time is a very important variable. Currently have it set to 0.25 seconds, and that corresponds to how often I'm calling the PID instruction. So the PID instruction, the equation that it's using needs to know how much time is passing between every time it updates its result. This is usually, or ideally, is a fixed interval, and you need to tell the equation or the instruction what that update rate is so that it can factor it into the equation. The CV limits are set to 100% and 0% since the output we're sending is to a control valve and we're sending it 0 to 100%. I did not configure a dead band. I'm not really utilizing the alarms, but if you wanted to configure them, you can do so on the alarms tab. Those would be alarms that are internal to the PID instruction. On the scaling, it's always critical that this is set up correctly. Otherwise, the loop will not control properly. here the PV is level, so I have it currently set up to 100 to 0, and then same on the engineering units. The unscaled min and max may vary based on what your IO is set up to be. But since I'm simulating everything here, I'm just keeping it just straight in engineering units. So that's why everything is 100 to 0. Same with the control variable. In this case, it's 0 to 100% to the flow control valve. So again, it is 0 to 100. I'm not utilizing a tieback, so I left that the default value. Under the tag tab, you can adjust the PID tag and the description associated with that tag. At the bottom here, you also see that it's showing you the current value of some of the things that it's calculating. For instance, the error, the output percent. It's also showing you what it's reading in as the process variable, which is something that's currently being calculated by the simulation logic, and also the current value of the set point. You can also check if there are any alarm statuses and some other statuses here in the bottom right. One thing to note is that, as I said, the update rate on this PID instruction was set at a quarter second inside the instruction, and that should agree with how often you are calling the instruction, and ideally that should be as unchanging as possible. There are several ways to do that. You can use, for instance, a timer to call it. Also, what I typically do is I will set up a periodic task and configure it with the desired update rate for my PID loops. This is a little less flexible, but typically what you want to do is decide on how quick your process is, and then or how fast your PIDs will need to respond to process changes. And that's going to obviously vary based on what type of loop it is. For instance, a temperature loop might be very slow, so you may not need a very quick update rate. But regardless, what you want to do is have a good way to ensure that you're calling it at a very defined rate. So what I've seen and what I typically like to do is, again, to set up a periodic task, configure it such that the period is the update rate of the PID that I need, and then set a priority such that it won't be interrupted more than is strictly necessary. So again, I'm using a periodic task to control how often I'm calling the PID. If you had a timer, obviously that would allow you to adjust it more easily, but it runs the risk of being subject to possibly being interrupted by other logic. So as I stated previously, the current set point is set at 25, and the loop will change its output to match any new set point changes. So here, if I change it to 35, you can see that the output is now increasing as it's trying to get the level up. Looks like it overshot a bit, so that would be a tuning issue. So now that it recognized that it overshot again, it brings the output back down. There's, and invariably with loops that aren't tuned exactly, there's going to be some hunting that will occur. And that's where you would want to do some tuning to try to minimize that to get something closer to ideal control. I currently have one of the two solenoid valves open, which results in an outflow. So for this level loop, the flow control valve can only add water, for instance, to the tank. So by having a solenoid valve that lets water out, there is a there's a mechanism for lowering the level that the PID then has to account for when it's adding. Still looks like it's doing some hunting on the level, but again, it's attempting to control around the new set point. If I open SV002, that will increase the outflow, which will drive the level down. But again, the PID should detect the change in the error value in order to try to maintain the given set point, which is, again, 35 currently. Looks like it's trying to hunt back up to 35, has a little bit of an overshoot. So again, it's going to continuously keep adjusting that output percent as it tries to get the level in the tank to 35%. If I adjust the set point again, since we were above, it decreases the output percent to decrease the amount of flow that's coming in. Looks like it undershot there a bit, so now it's coming back up. And again, it overshot there through the 25. So looks like there certainly could be more tuning that could be done here. What I would probably do is add some integral gain versus proportional. But regardless, the PID is currently set up. It's acting in the correct direction. It's responding to both process changes and set point changes, and it's doing so in the correct direction. Further tuning could get it closer to that tight control that you would probably expect, but PID tuning is a fairly nebulous topic, and I felt that it would be best to exclude it from this example.